this module, we'll look at the overall CalEnviroScreen results for the entire state of California. Here are the CalEnviroScreen results for the entire state. This map shows all of the census tracts in California, color-coded to reflect their overall CalEnviroScreen score. Each census tract is sorted into one of 10 colors, or categories. Here, the census tracts are divided equally so that each category represents 10% of the state's census tracts. The legend shown in the top right of the map shows the 10 categories in ranging from green, representing the lowest scoring areas, to red, representing the highest scoring areas, with yellowish colors in between. A higher score represents a relatively higher pollution burden and more vulnerable populations. All census tracts were assigned a CalEnviroScreen score. Each score falls into one of the 10 categories shown here. Let's take a closer look at the results in different regions of California. This map shows the Los Angeles and San Bernardino areas. This map shows the San Francisco Bay Area. This map shows the San Joaquin Valley from Stockton down to Bakersfield. As you can see from these maps, CalEnviroScreen scores vary across different regions of the state. However, communities across the state vary in the types of pollution burden and population characteristics that can result in a high score. A community in the San Francisco Bay Area may have different concerns than a community in the San Joaquin Valley. Since the CalEnviroScreen model uses information from many different indicators, there could be different factors that influence the overall CalEnviroScreen score. For example, here is a census tract in Oakland within the San Francisco Bay Area. This census tract's CalEnviroScreen score places it in the top 10% of scores across the state. The pollution burden score here is high, but not as high compared to some parts of the state. But some indicators do score highly, such as traffic density, cleanup sites, and impaired water bodies. The population characteristics score represents different kinds of vulnerability. It is very high compared to the rest of the state, with high-scoring indicators like the rate of asthma and babies born low birth weight, as well as housing burden. The combination of the medium-high pollution burden score along with a very high population characteristics score results in an overall CalEnviroScreen score within the top 10% of scores statewide. Now, let's go to another census tract just outside of Ontario in San Bernardino County. This tract also scores in the top 10% of scores across the state. However, the factors contributing to the pollution burden and population characteristics scores here are different. In this census tract, the pollution burden score is very high relative to the rest of the state and has high scoring indicators like ozone, PM2.5, diesel particulate matter, traffic density, and drinking water. The population characteristics score is not as high as some other parts of the state, such as the census tract we just reviewed in Oakland. But some indicators do score high, like cardiovascular disease. This table compares the two census tracts in Oakland and Ontario. These communities with similar overall CalEnviroScreen scores are burdened by different kinds of pollution indicators. They also have different types of vulnerability based on their population characteristics scores. One of the values of using CalEnviroScreen is that it allows people concerned about environmental justice and the cumulative impacts of pollution on communities in California to identify areas impacted by multiple burdens. It also helps us to understand some of the specific issues in different communities.